songs are always about legends of, for example, Amazonic legends. So it's what people's beliefs, the mystical powers of this plant called Tambatajá, for example, or the other one, a little bird that sounds like a flute that's called Wirapuru. That's one of the, our songs, Wirapuru. And at the songs, it's always a story about these legends. It's really interesting.
I think one of the important features one of the most beautiful features about folk songs is that the folk songs melodies are normally quite simple, and because they're simple, they're easy to be passed down from generations to generations, and that makes the culture still alive. And people in the modern age, they're still able to relate to the music that was of the past, and they're able to appreciate the culture and the history behind all these songs.
Would you like to add anything to that?
Yes, this is music that is passed fathers to sons. Mm. And you know, Brazil is a gigantic country. It's a continental country. So our culture is what brings us together for like a nation. That's this music, this folk music that brings us like for united us as a country. I think the future of classical music is what I'm doing here in this concert. This mixture with popular and classical, I think this is the future of classical music, because it's already doing in worldwide. A lot of groups are doing it. We have Il Divo, we have Capella. We have lots of groups that do that, and they are operatic voices, but with a popular mix. I think this is the future of classical music.
Hello, my name is Taiana Froes, and
I'm Benjamin Wu, and together we'll be performing for Piano Botanica 2016.
At the 11th of September.
At the Symphony Stage at Singapore Botanic Gardens. And we hope to see you there.
See you there.